Before this video starts, I have an announcement to make. The highly requested Click Productions merch is out now at the link at the top of the description or my pinned comment. When you click this, you'll find the official Click Productions design as well as the cause why the hell not design on hoodies, t-shirts, long sleeve t-shirts, as well as kid sizes. And to make it very reasonable, for the time being, everything is listed much lower than anything else on this site. I made sure to put everything well below the site's average price. The Click Productions design is of course a representation of this YouTube that you've all helped me grow to this incredible point, and I flipped cause why the hell not into a mantra that you can interpret however you like. For me personally, I said cause why the hell not when I spent all my money as a 17-year-old kid on some YouTube equipment with no reason but my own hope to do so. Well, here we are. Support it if you like, I can't control you, but the links are in the description as well as the top of the comments. And now, alright. Happy 45th birthday to Andre 3000, king, legend, icon, all that weird stuff. You know, these days, and especially right now with the heightened talks of Michael Jordan with the Last Dance documentary, the LeBron James and Michael Jordan arguments tend to reach all-time highs like every week. And well, the tension was diffused a little bit when I believe LeBron himself said something about thinking about he would be a good teammate with Michael Jordan. Then of course every publication talked about it a little bit. Shannon Sharp said that they would get 10 rings together and so on and so forth. So as we send off 29-year pro 60-year-old LeBron James, 46 overall. Yeah, that's right. I completely just ruined his career just to bring him back into the NBA. What in the living hell would happen if LeBron James and Michael Jordan were teammates for their entire career? That's it. That's the video. Do I need to say much more? Whether it was Stephen A. Smith, a random commenter, or my left sock that brought me this video idea, it is one of the most, let's just say, what's a good word? Compelling video ideas you could ever imagine. I don't know if that even makes sense. Who the hell cares? These are the official Michael Jordan and LeBron James players from their, well, you know, respective draft classes in the 2K The Story draft class thing. For LeBron, they got him as ceiling George Gervin and floor Andrew Wiggins. And for Mike, his ceiling just says straight up Hall of Fame. Yeah, makes sense. So either way, they're both, you know, Hall of Famers, like, already. Not the best three-point shooter, needs work for weaknesses for Mike, and has trouble taking contact on drives. Oh yeah, Bill Laimbeer would agree. Then he became a different beast. LeBron doesn't really have any crazy weaknesses as of right now, but yeah, I mean, he has a nice shooting form. Rookie LeBron wasn't the greatest I don't know, whatever. But anyways, the NBA draft lottery. Now, this is the deal, right? Before we even, you know, let him finish this. Actually, well, I guess we could look at the lottery odds. Okay, the Knicks won, Pistons, Bulls, great. Whoever wins this draft lottery, I'm going to be trading them the second pick. It's really simple as that. And we'll just trade one of their best players or whatever, the player that fits most in a trade for the second pick. You get it, right? Great. Now, we're actually going to watch this because this is like the lottery of all lotteries. The Grizzlies just jumped from 11 to top 4. The Hawks moved in. Pistons fell down to 5. Bulls are at 4, right? No? Okay, Hawks go 4. Number 3, Bulls got the highest odds here, which means that, well, what will happen? The Grizzlies, great. It is now between the Bulls and the Knicks for Michael Jordan and LeBron James. One of these teams is going to lose their top 2 pick, and it is the Bulls that lose their pick. The New York Knicks remain at number 1 and will select, well, both of them. I swear I didn't rig this. You know this. The Knicks are just horrible, but not for long. I'm gonna actually try and construct a trade that's gonna work. It's 27th one, this next year's one from us. Oh, they agreed. Alright, well, sorry RJ Barrett. Great time having you here, but yeah, you're out of here. Hey, look, the Pistons hire head coach Jacob Underwood. But yeah, honestly, trading RJ was logical considering that, you know, we're gonna have Michael Jordan at the 2 now, you know? Fantastic. I don't know why the Bulls would ever accept that, but sure. Pretty sure Gar Pax is still running the Bulls in this league, so two incompetent front offices just making a nice deal with each other. All right, we'll never know who would have went first because I felt like jumping in just so I didn't waste my time and they didn't pick him for some reason. So yep, LeBron's here. And secondly, welcome Mike. I actually have some pretty cool aspects that I added into this, which I'll tell you about in 3, 2, 1. LeBron James and Michael Jordan. And well, to start, LeBron is number 6 and Mike is number 45. I was gonna give one of them number 23, but I said to hell with it. We're just gonna give them both their alternate numbers. New careers, new aspects, new weird stuff. I don't know. But yeah, here the hell we are. Secondly, for one, this LeBron face scan for his rookie years is absolutely disgusting. So after 5 years for the both of them, I'm gonna take Mike's hair off and make LeBron look like how he did in his Miami days, basically. And yeah, that's it. We got Jordan Clarkson. Thanks. LeBron just has a bunch of Bron James gold badges that you would expect from LeBron, you know? Mike has Hall of Fame relentless finisher with a bunch of, well, Michael Jordan badges that you would expect, I guess, right? Bronze catch and shoot for that shot in the UNC game. And yeah, once again, I did absolutely nothing to either of these players. We also have Shareef O'Neal. And yeah, that's it. Hey, Mitchell Robinson, the best player on the team, I guess. When would Mitchell Robinson ever be better than LeBron James, Michael Jordan? Just imagine the day. Oh, well, he has pass fake, Maestro. All right, he deserves it. So, season number 1. Oh boy, our starting point guard, Kadeem Allen. David Fizzle, I just really don't want you here. You know who I do want? You know, we'll bring Lucas around for this time. Let my guy get some shine. It's been a lot of Jacob Underwood recently. He has a whole Forbes article. Before I forget, shout out to Cameron Chi, who said, thanks for reminding me to like the video. I don't speak English. Yeah, I got nothing. But hey, if you like the videos, you could like the video. It's really that simple. You get it. So, crazily enough, neither LeBron James or Michael Jordan is an all-star in their first year. Then again, they're probably just like stealing the ball from each other. You know, they're young. They still need some experience. Hassan Whiteside, one-time all-star. Look at the rookie of the year race. LeBron and Mike, neck and neck. But yeah, there's their stats. They're both doing pretty well, as we're doing a lot better than the Knicks will probably do in real life next year. Hey, we have Draymond. Wait, what the hell? We traded Mitchell Robinson for Cash Winston. Why did we do that? Why? Well, that makes things 12 times harder, but hey, then we just test the greatness of Michael Jordan and LeBron James. How many years do you think until they win a championship? Leave a comment. You don't have to. You can just decide to if you feel like it. I can't control you. Imagine they don't. Hello, MVP guy. Hopefully this isn't a long-lasting thing this time around. Rookie of the year, LeBron James. So he averaged 25-5-7-2-1, while Mike averaged 24-4-6, and yeah, you get it. They had pretty incredibly similar rookie seasons. Fine by me, honestly. They worked out a lot better than I thought in year number one. D. Schroed, Corner Kawhi, LeBron James, All-NBA second team. No Michael Jordan. Well, we see who has taken the early lead in the quote-unquote competition. Actually, no, forget the competition. They're on the same team. We're trying to win rings here. Alright, yeah, there's gonna be a competition either way, for God's sake. But hey, Michael Jordan, All-Defensive second team. We are the 6th seed against the 76ers. Match of the century, LeBron James versus Tobias Harris, and Julius Randle versus Joel Embiid. We're like both equally awful at spacing. Yeah, we both suck. So who's less awful? Well, we're down 3-2, and we lost in game 7 by 20. Here's Bron's playoff numbers, and here's, that's Julius Randle. Here's Mike's playoff numbers. Oh boy, 100% from 3, aka made 1 for 1. Yeah, I definitely wouldn't have thought that Julius Randle and Joel Embiid was a good idea. Hi, Kevin. Nicholas Young retired. Hey, can we get the first pick again somehow? Oh, actually, we traded away our pick to the Bulls. I forgot about that. Yeah, it was worth it. Nefali Dante, welcome. And here the hell goes the progression. LeBron James, 88. Michael Jordan, 86. He developed like 5 more badges. Mike got a couple more himself. Actually, Mike got like 14 more. Hey, look who it is. D. Schroed. Wait, what? All right, guys. I know that Kadeem Allen was starting, but we didn't need every like okay point guard in the league. And hey, Norvell Pell is here. And by the grace of God, Julius Randle is gone. Fantastic. This year should go much better. Season number 2. Hopefully, I remember in season number 5. Remind me to change their faces, okay? Great. Thank you. Yeah, they're both playing 38 minutes a game this year, which is a lot more than last year, I think. Lucas, hello. How are you doing today? By the way, I got no type of first scoring option. They're just going to figure it out, you know? Why the hell would I have bias? Our bench literally doesn't know what defense is. Devontae Graham, Jordan Clarkson, and Kevin Knox might as well just sit down on that end. Team LeBron and Team Mike. Okay. You know I'm joking. It's year 2, for God's sake. Let's temper our expectations. Okay, but wait. I did expect you guys, like, one of you to be on an all-star team, though. But all right, you know, we could take the team approach, I guess. Wait, so LeBron is 3rd in the MVP voting, but he didn't make the all-star team? And yeah, wait, how did he make the 2nd? You know, I'm not going to question it. I already did. Hey, it's Bobo, Raptors superstar. You know, it feels really weird seeing LeBron older than Jordan. Somebody just give Mike the same exact birthday. Fantastic. While LeBron is up there in the MVP, Mike's basically still doing the same exact thing and shooting like a whole, what is that, 10% higher from field goal? Great. They're playing incredible, which is why we're the 4th seed. Who am I kidding? It's probably Dennis Schroeder. What if his name was Luke and not Luca? Would he be as cool? Why do they give Evan Mobley the SpongeBob arms when he was trying to get into the salty Splatoon? Bully Boy, D-Gar, and Quinn. Oh, there we go. Equal recognition. Michael Jordan and LeBron James, All-NBA second team together alongside each other, best friends, brothers, I don't know, you say something. I do too much talking, it's not like I'm making a YouTube video or anything. Hey, Michael Jordan, All-Defensive First Team. Fantastic, they compliment each other well. Who the hell would have thought? We're the first seed? If Michael Jordan loses to Gary Trent Jr., I'll end the video right now. Thank you very much, 4-0. Okay, well, Marcus Smart's annoying as hell, so I won't blame. Oh god, they have Mitchell Robinson. He wants revenge on Norvell Pell. Oh, here the hell we go. Yeah, 2-2, great. 3-2 us, okay, can we just, nope, 3-3. Game 7, I want to see LeBron and Jordan in a game together, that'd be kind of cool. Yeah, it's not gonna be this game, we blew him out. Dennis Schroeder, the game 7 performer. LeBron, 19-7-13, Mike, 27-5, and Michael Carter-Williams, 8 points. For the record, Mike put up 49 points this season, and LeBron put up 43. Alright, Atlanta, okay. Oh, well, you have LaMelo, and, okay, yeah, okay, fine. LaMelo versus Michael Jordan, though, can you really, like, yeah, okay, great. 3-1, and, can we just, oh my god, what the hell? Why can't you guys ever, we won by 1? Oh, LeBron, 21-6-12, Mike, 22, I mean, they haven't really choked yet, but, now we're in the finals. Draymond Green versus Zach Randolph, I'd love to see that 1v1. I'm not intimidated. Michael Jordan, LeBron James, can you guys, like, do something here, just get it over with? In year number 2, for God's sake. Yeah, no, we just got blown out in game 1. Ron and Mike played fine, but, no, you're kidding me. Draymond, what the hell? You're supposed to be good at defense. How the hell you let Zach Randolph drop 30 on you? He's like 46. One game 2, Mike 36 points. Thank you. Ron flirting with a triple-double. Let Gordon Hayward be the highest score every game. We'll win every game. Yeah, we won another game. LeBron 27-10-10. Mike 18 on 8 for 20, but we won't talk about it. We won. We just stormed all the way the hell back at the end of the game. Just look at the fourth quarter right there. And we won. They're very, very, they're working very well together. We're up 3-1. Here the hell we go. Never mind. We lost that one. We could try again in game six. Fantastic. It only took two full seasons. And in the second, look at Devin Booker's sportsmanship dribbling out the ball. Oh God, now he's going for the bucket. He got clamped up. Oh boy, Mikal Bridges post fadeaway. We're scared. He actually hit it. The New York Knicks 2000 and 22 NBA champions. LeBron James finals MVP. What up? Mike got to hold the trophy at least. Look at Draymond. I never even put two and two together that LeBron and Draymond are on the same team. Devontae Graham. Michael Jordan, 35.7 rebounds and 6 assists on 14 for 17 shooting to close it out. He averaged 25, 5, and 5 in the playoffs, while LeBron averaged, 25, 6, and 8. Similar and effective. Thank you very much for the 13 and 10, Mr. Dennis. For God's sake, they won a ring, and we only got 190 overall out of the two guys that are both going to be 99s. What the hell? Let's just move on. I could tell this is going to be one hell of a long video. Zach Randolph retired. Welcome to the team, Jerry Brady. More than likely the new James Jones. Not gonna lie. I forgot to put in the draft class, I guess. So those guys are coming in a year late, like LeBron James Jr. and Mikey, Mr. Kuminga. Whatever, stuff happens. Variety is cool. Of course, we got to extend the qualifying offer for Reuben Buford. LeBron is a 92. And Mikal, shout out Troyden, it's a 90. Bron still doesn't have any Hall of Fame badges, but he got 27 badges total now. And Mike, he's got an acrobat. Hooray. Hello, Derek Favors. Rodney, Dusty Early, and Dustin Reed. Season number 3. Norvell has a 33-point shot. We have him at power forward next to Derek Favors. That doesn't sound good. I almost missed Draymond, even though it took me until now to realize that he was gone. Ah, yes, finally. Don't know why it took this long, but Michael Jordan and LeBron James, side by side, all-stars. Hello, Malcolm Brogdon. LeBron is third in the MVP race with LeBron-type numbers. I guess we let Sharif go, and now he's most improved player. Young Luka, Archie Clark, Lobe, and Lucas, coach of the year with 57 wins. LeBron James, All-NBA first team with probably the same numbers that we saw like 10 seconds ago, right? Yeah, just about. And Mike, he didn't make any of the teams. I mean, made the defensive team, but oh yeah, it makes sense. Yeah, Bron stole the ball from him this season. And Bron even made the all-defensive second team himself. Regardless, we're the first seed. Oh God, sorry, Malcolm Brogdon. We got to do it to you again. No, we're down 2-0. We're down 3-0. Are we going to get swept in the first round? Yeah, we're going to win this game. So are we about to come back now? Can't believe this is where we're getting our tough matchup. Okay, we just barely won this game. We're in a game 7 in the first round. Well, I mean, it's better than losing 4-0. Our most intense series yet. And we have a pretty firm grasp on this one. Never mind. 113 with 5 seconds left and we have the ball. Number 45, Mike, set to bring in the ball. Well, take the ball from the inbound. You get it. LeBron isn't in the game. I would assume he fouled out. Mike, 4 seconds. 3 seconds. Mike, pull up midi. Mike! Yo. Michael Jordan. Wait, where is he looking at? Hold on. He takes a deep gaze into the crowd. Continues on his trek towards the basket. Sabonis completely unable to catch him. Mike, a few feet out from the free throw line. Clean. That is how you come back from down 3-0 and win a series. And of course, LeBron wasn't even fouled out. He was just on the bench. What the hell? Look at Bron's incredible reaction as Jordan hits the shot. His lips didn't even move. He has no clue what the hell is going on. Actually, he's more so pissed. Why is he walking right by? Why did he just shove Lucas? Is this Scottie Pippen, Tony Kukoc, Phil Jackson 2.0? Storylines developing. 11 for 17 shooting. Yep, definitely how you finish out of game 7. All we need is for Doug McDermott to not hit a shot here. That'd be a great thing to happen, right? Okay, yeah, nobody really open. Brogdon from half court. Thank God. Well, that's one hell of a way to start off a playoff run. Bron still led 20 and 11. All right, Boston, you got the same team except Mitchell Robinson. For God's sake, why did we trade you? Here the hell we go. Can we get an easy round this time? Thank you. What the hell? The Raptors have KD, Siakam, and Gobert. This should be one hell of a series. Okay, we're up 2-0 and we're up 3. What? Great job, Kevin. We beat him down 4-1. Look at the game 3 stats. 34 from LeBron, 30 from Mike. Beautiful. And now the NBA Finals against, Anthony Davis and his LeBron replacement, also known as Hassan Whiteside. I guess it worked enough for him to get to the finals in the Western Conference. In fairness, you played the Timberwolves and they got Rondae Hollis-Jefferson. Game 1 is ours. LeBron 37-7-7. Game 2 is a very, very close effort. Let's jump in. Who the hell cares? I'm trying to see LeBron and Mike as much as possible when playing together. Zeke Nnaji. I just wanted to point out that this guy just looks like he's wearing an obnoxiously fake mustache. Girl in the back looks devastated. Terry Rozier and Anthony Davis, duo of the future. We gotta pass it in someday. Okay, there we go. Michael Jordan to the basket. Mike goes right around Danny. Wait, that's not even Danny Green. I don't know. Oh, wait, that's Roberson. The man's been chilling at the crib with Rachel Demeter for 4 years. He finally got back on the court, and his first task is Michael Jordan. You thought Mike was going to miss free throws? Man, can hit him with his eyes closed. Wait a second. You did not. No. I'm about to banish Terry Rozier from the league after this game. AD in the post against, I forgot that guy's name. AD going right. He's getting doubled. AD out to Miles Bridges, and that's a green. I have a weird feeling that it's over. Bron over to Mike, wide open midi. Never mind. Maybe it's not over. That's that's the connection right there. You seen that easy, quick dime? Rozier, you don't deserve to make shots with that number on. Come on now, get the screen from AD and miss real quick. There you go, screen from AD, and down to AD. Oh, God, he's wide open. Back out to Rozier, over to AD. AD ISO'd on the right wing, down to Oladipo. Oladipo on Jordan. Oladipo layup is off, rebounded by Jordan. Jordan on the break. Mike down to LeBron. Bron, what the hell are you doing? No! You're joking, right? Now, granted, we had no time really left in the shot clock. As you can see up there, there's like 1.9 left. But Bron, I don't care how close up Miles was to you. I don't care if he was pissing you off. Why the hell did you just bop the ball off his head? You don't stop at the three-point line. But yeah, we lost. Leading scorer, Dennis Schroeder. Just watch a clip of Mikey Williams dunking on flight. Shout out to Mikey, man. Inspirational. LeBron, incredible game as we bounce back and take a win. And we won again. LeBron and Mike, neck and neck. And, well, you know, the winning thing. 3-1. Forget a loss. We win enough to lose sometimes. Quote, Gandhi. We won. Hold on. Terry just stole the ball. Terry on the other end. What the hell? Why do they just want to waste my time? All right, screw this. I'm simcasting to the end. At least pass the free throws, for God's sake. What the hell is this camera view? What is this, Miles? AD for three. What the hell? All right, we're still up by whatever. We must have missed a shot because they have the ball, but it's going to be over, right? Yeah, Oladipo for three, and he hit it. Oh, my God, and we won by one. That is it. Back-to-back championships for young MJ and young Bron. And yes, emphasis on the young bees. For God's sake, we got a lot of time left. LeBron, finals MVP once again. Devontae Graham. Incredible game from our big three, honestly, because Dennis is king, as we hold Keon Johnson to 5-for-13 shooting and win another championship. LeBron's final stats and our overall playoff numbers. Yeah, Bron definitely took the initiative this time around. Fantastic. Sorry, Melo, I didn't realize you were on the Lakers. Jimmer Fredette retired. Terrell Cameron looks like he's going through a midlife crisis. Oh boy, Clint Capella signed with the Kings. LeBron James goes up by 4 to a 96, and Michael Jordan 93. Micah now has Hall of Fame pick dodger and pickpocket. LeBron has finally developed acrobat and relentless finisher. Fantastic. There's still only 22 years old. Bobby Portis is back, going to season number 4. All right, Bobby Portis and Derek Favors might be even worse than last year. Hey, either way, we're winning rings. LeBron and Mike, two-time All-Star, and I'm sad to announce that they hindered Jusuf Nurkic's progress because somehow he's only got one. Still top 5 in the MVP race for Mr. James. Whoa. Number 1 and number 2 in the DPOY race, our two guys. Yeah, let's just finish the season now. I'm scared. Hello, Giannis Antetokounmpo. Kuminga looking like a grown 28-year-old man. Why did LeVar name his children like this? Defensive Player of the Year, Michael Jordan with 23-7, and you see the stats. That's what happens when you get Hall of Fame pick dodger. Well, I'm assuming second on that list was LeBron, who did just about as well himself. Taylor Jenkins, LeBron first team, and Mike once again somehow, someway didn't make a team, but he's good at the defense thing, and so is Bron. We're the second seed against Miami, who have Juwan Evans starting point guard, and dismantled Blake Griffin. Yup, cool little 4-2, thank you very much. I was kind of scared there for a second. Hey, look who it is. Usman Garuba versus Bobby Portis, matchup of the century. Okay, who am I kidding? It's TJ McConnell, return to Philadelphia versus Dennis Schroeder. Yeah, we won. Wait, what? We didn't win. We definitely didn't win. We lost. Oh my God. 40-10 from the Embiid guy. Oh, that's the end of our season, and we are not going to three-peat. Mike had 29, Bron had 34-12, and playoff numbers. They're all right. Fantastic. I mean, we're going to get the three-peats eventually, hopefully, maybe. The god of making the playoffs but not winning championships, JJ Redick retired. Only the Cavs could draft another LeBron. Larry Bradley, yeah, close enough. Lambros Dorikas, our next draft and stash player. Bron, 98 overall, and Mike, 96 overall. So Michael Jordan all of a sudden just went from however many finishing badges he had Hall of Fame to like 7 or 8, and they all make perfect sense, along with Hall of Fame volume shooter. Oh my God. Yep, they're starting to go God mode, I think. LeBron, clutch shooter, tireless shooter, volume shooter. Yeah, believe me, Bron, 13 years down the line or something like that, you're going to hit a really cool, like, one-handed shot over OG Anunoby in the semifinals. And tireless defender. Oh yeah, I forgot that they were free agents, probably because obviously they're re-signing, you know? Mike signed a 5-year deal, Bron signed a 4-year deal. Actually, I'm just going to make it 5 for the sake of my sanity. Speaking of that, it's year number 5. So let's now transform into older LeBron James and bald Michael Jordan, if he ever loads. There he goes. Yep, these are like the scary version of these players, not just the young, energetic versions, I guess. I don't know. I just realized Dennis Schroeder is gone and now I'm sad again. All right, season number 5. Just checking in, Lucas. And there it is. It took 3 All-Star appearances and an identity change, but they're starters now. My God, they're number 2 and 3 in the MVP race and they're averaging almost identical numbers. But Steph. Yeah, he's probably gonna win it, right? Yeah, there goes Steph. Michael Jordan, DPOY, once again, being Michael Jordan. Nas, me true long. LeBron James, All-NBA first team with, let me guess, LeBron numbers, right? Oh, yeah, there they go. What's wild is, Michael Jordan went DPOY and I believe had better numbers than this, and he was on the, yeah, what,
the hell?
He's on the third team. I don't know. As long as they're making the All-NBA teams and being good at basketball, I guess. And we're playing Miami again. Nas, me, True Long. Why the hell they got the most random point guards? Cool, we won 4-1. Orlando, you want to contest us? Pascal left after we beat down him, Kevin Durant, and Rudy Gobert. And now it's Imani Bates and Cade Cunningham. They're kind of scary, but can we just win real quick? Thank you very much. Speaking of Kevin Durant and Rudy Gobert, and now of Nasir Little instead of Pascal Siakam. Can we win again? They're the first seed, though. That's kind of never mind. James Harden in the NBA Finals. That's like a first. Well, him and Russ are looking for their first ring. Will it happen? I don't know. First game is ours. And we lost the second game because, I don't know, Juwan Evans. Third game is going to be a win. They're dropping like almost exact numbers. We won another game. We're up 3-1 because LeBron James is good at basketball. And TJ Leaf, well, you know, your 10 rebounds didn't really hold up. And on the verge of ring number 3, it was a kind of close game for a minute, but it looks like we're kind of pulling away, you know? Well, I mean, it is pretty close. But yeah, free throw game, you know? They're chanting MVP for the Jordan guy. Great, he's good at hitting free throws. He hit the first and second. Yeah, I would assume he's kind of, there you go. Houston, good try, but it's over. Okay, well, Harden hit a shot, but we don't care. As long as we don't turn the ball over, that'd be a good idea. Oh God, why do we make Devontae Graham shoot the free throws over Michael Jordan? Never mind. Juwan Evans with the game on the line. That's the man you give the ball to. Russell Westbrook for 3. Yeah, leave him open. There you go. Great job. That's it. Championship number 3 in just 5 years. LeBron and whoever the hell that guy is, number 26. LeBron Finals MVP again. Mike's always going to hold that big body trophy, though. Devontae Graham. Yeah, Devontae Graham at 26 and 12. Forget Mike and LeBron. But yeah, LeBron played, you know, he had 29 and 9 per game in the playoffs, while Mike had 26, 6 and 6. Wait, no, that's 5. I know I'm the rounding up guy, but I can't be incorrect. LeBron, thank you. Fantastic. It's only 2025, and they're kind of successful, you know? Eric Moreland retired. Christoph Silvestri. For future reference, that guy's name is Damon Kerr. Well, LeBron is officially a 99, and Mike is a 97. You know, gained some more of those Hall of Fame badges. Well, Mike actually didn't, but who cares? They're really good at the basketball thing. You know, we won a bunch of championships already. Pushing along at about the same pace as we head into season number 6. Starting center, Nafali Dante. Mike and LeBron starting alongside each other. Michael Jordan, number 1 in the MVP race. Well, that's one hell of a jump. I mean, yeah, the guy's averaging 37 and 8 with 3 steals. Oh my God. Michael Jordan, in his 6th season, the most valuable player of the NBA. I mean, for God's sake, the guy averaged God-tier numbers on 60% shooting. He's even kind of learned how to shoot the 3. You know, 37 isn't that bad. Deion Johnston. Hello, Shea. Had to get revenge on the Clippers by going to the Lakers. Michael Jordan, Defensive Player of the Year as well. And Coach of the Year, Lucas, the King. Bron and Mike, All-NBA First Team. Lanny, you guys just want to move real quick? Yeah, I really don't want to deal with you right now. I don't want to have MVP Michael Jordan alongside. There you go. The great. Second round, Orlando. Thank you very much. And third round, Charlotte. Thank you very much as well. We're starting to feel unstoppable. As I say that, we're going to lose to Clint Capella, probably. Here we go. What the hell did I say? We're on the verge of losing to Clint. You know, the King's got a chance here to take the lead. Let's just see what the hell happens. Why am I doing this myself? I'm just bound to watch a free throw game. Who are the best defensive players in the league? They got Denny trying to get the ball? Yeah, no, LeBron exists. Oh boy, down to Denny. Denny with the ball on LeBron. Denny going left, clamped up by Bron. Why are they trying to run an isolation? Call a screen. Denny cannot handle this pressure. Denny to the basket, goes left, puts up the shot, misses. Rebounded by the King. Zubac puts it up, misses again. Zubac again. Yo, we may have some kind of weak big men, but they held it down right there, I guess. This aside from the rebounding thing, why the hell do you guys shoot identical from the field? When the hell did Miles Bridges get here? Who the hell knows? Not like he matters, just another bench piece. Fantastic, we're off to a good note. Second game, once again a win. Why do you guys keep putting up the same numbers? I guess that's why people compare you a lot, you know? Third game, once again a win. And fourth game, the dynasty continues. Shout out Jay-Z. The New York Knicks, I believe just a 25, 26-year-old LeBron and MJ, win ring number 4. It is 4, right? I don't know. I always lose count nowadays. Mike and Derek Favors embracing each other. Lucas and his old high school point guard, De'Aaron Fox. Yeah, I don't know what the hell I'm talking about anymore. Michael Jordan Finals MVP this time around. Probably deserved it. You know, he did the whole regular season MVP thing. There goes that guy again. I forgot his name already. Jesus, Mike. 43, 11, and 10. For the record, Bron put up 56 in the game this season, and Mike put up 52. So, yeah, they're getting close to their career highs. Kinda. 31 and 9 per game for Mike in the finals. Here's their playoff numbers. They absolutely dominated. They both averaged, well, over 31 points per game. Kareem Main retired. Bron gets some more badges. You know, Mike, same thing goes for him. We get it. They're Michael Jordan, LeBron James, for God's sake. They're 97 and 99 overall at 25 years old. Damon Kerr making feasible progress, while our savior and locker room standout, Devontae Graham, is an 83. Season number 7. Been Team Giannis and Team Stephen for like 7 years. Michael Jordan and LeBron James, 5-time All-Stars, and, you know, starters alongside each other because they got to be alongside each other like best friends now. Hey, look who it is. Dennis Schroeder, 1-time All-Star. I won't even be mad that you left. Michael Jordan, 37 and 7 with 3 steals a game. Number 1 in the MVP race again. Bron still hanging on here at 4. I mean, he's like eliminating Giannis from existence right now. Kinda. You know, yeah, he is. Oh, Stephen Curry MVP. All right, Michael, come back. back another year, I guess. Michael's son, Jerry Jordan. And there goes Michael, DPOY again. Samuel Harden. And Lucas, who I think got a new suit. Incredible. I like the fashion sense. Mike and LeBron, first team. Just look at their numbers. We want to doubt their dominance at all. Do we really want to look at the Orlando Magic roster? I don't know. I mean, it looked kind of good, actually. So maybe we're going to lose. No. Okay, the Bulls have Zion. That's instantly scary, but are we that scared? You know, we have LeBron, who's like Zion, but oh, God. We're in Game 7. We lost. We lost in Game 7 to the Chicago Bulls. Ironically, Zion didn't really even do anything. It was Chet Holmgren. Mike shot 8 for 11. Bron did his Bron thing, but yeah, I guess the rest of the team couldn't hold up. Oh, my God. Who is this? Brian Antoine. Man, as Bron's Deadeye and shot 0 for 5 from 3. Disgusting. Hello, Doncic. DJ Carton. Carton. Sounds like somebody who bought all the DJ equipment in the world and didn't realize they didn't know how to DJ. Utah. And the Lakers really fell off. Or they're just tanking for the hell of it. Wale. Mike is a 98. Bron's solidified 99. Mike gained a hell of a lot of shooting badges, as well as Hall of Fame tight handles. Although, yeah, Bron's getting better at the whole basketball thing, too. Damon Kerr still holding in strong. I mean, 3 and D wing. That's exactly what we need on this team. Lambros Dorikas. And Nick Claxton is here now as we go into season number 8. Starting point guard, Ty Jerome. Can I just tell you when they're not starters, if they make some sort of change? Yeah, that sounds like a good idea. But for the time being, Michael Jordan's still number 1 in the MVP race. Bron, 3. And they're both just about as good a defense as you could ever be. Michael Jordan, 2-time MVP. As you can see, he doesn't need a 3-point shot, I guess. And DPOY again, because why the hell not? Kristofi Silverstreet. Or just Kristof... You know what? I don't care. Hey, Jacob Underwood, Coach of the Year. The King himself. We got a lot of kings around here, but hey, that's how we rock. Kyrie Irving, All-NBA First Team. Okay, fine. LeBron, Mike, yeah, you get it. So yeah, now, like, they're both starting to just take every shot during the regular season, and nobody else really cares. Just balling out. The second seed against Giannis, right? Yeah, there he goes. Caris LeVert would be a good fit on the Bucks, but you know who we really care about? Ibu Dianko-Baji. Fantastic. Are we gonna win the series, please? That'd be a good thing. Great 4-0 sweep. Sorry, Giannis. God, we made this man have 7 turnovers with 6 for 15 shooting. Yeah, bad for Giannis, you know? Second round, hey, Robert Williams, you're trying to lose? Fantastic. Nice to see you comply with our rules. And William Wells, Kevin Porter. Okay, they have James Wiseman. He's pretty good. But yeah, they're the 8 seed. So we're gonna lose to the 8 seed? Nope. The Houston Rockets. Once again, playing this team in the finals, except Russell Westbrook and James Harden retired. Now they have Lauri Markkanen and Michael Porter Jr. who's in the news for all the wrong reasons right now. Can we just like win this real quick? Oh, that'd be a good... Whoa, we're down 2-1. All right, never mind. Simcast. Like this does anything different. I mean, we're just gonna see if we could jump in or not. Oh my God, we're about to lose another game. Are we really gonna lose in the finals? We're down 3-1. This would be very poetic to like make him blow a 3-1 lead though. Brown would have to do it in both careers. Yep, we won another game. 41 from Mike. He's averaging 35 in this playoff run. You know, Bron's averaging 26-7. We just need 2 more games and we'll be champions. Come on now. We came back from a 3-0 for God's sake. Yeah, there you go. Mike, once again, good at basketball. Game 7 in New York. And, yep, in both careers, Bron James is gonna, well, you know, make teams blow 3-1 leads. It's just in his blood. I would enjoy shooting a shot with LeBron James if they would just like an open layup real quick. There you go, Scottie Pippen Jr. Come on, Bron, I want to dunk with you real quick. Bron to the basket. Bron hop set right around. Oh my, I suck. Okay, I'm kidding. I just don't care. Okay, they subbed out Bron. So, Kerr, you want a shot real quick? Let's go to the corner. Kerr in the corner. Kerr for 3. Okay, yeah. 5-time, I think, NBA champions. I don't know. I've never actually fact-checked it. I'm just trying to go off my memory. Man, I'm smart. Tristan Thompson and Michael Jordan really having a great time. Tristan Thompson would be the closest thing to Mike's Dennis Rodman of this generation. Not at all, but he's just the closest thing for this Knicks team. Mike, 31-5-7-5. Bron, 29-7-11-2-3. Yeah, you get it. They're really good. Oh, that was 4 rings before this. So wait, do we have Mike finals MVP with 37 a game? Yeah, we got 5 rings already. It's only been like 8 years. Here's our specific playoff stats. Willie Trilly Billy Cauley Stein retired. Why would he ever make his middle name Trilly? Or whatever the hell it is. I don't care. Dwight Swift. LeBron 99. Mike 98. Although it says 99 on the top right for some reason. I don't know. Damon Kerr is genuinely really good at the basketball thing. Well, he was the 7th pick, I guess. What would we trade for him? It was definitely a good trade. Mike now has Hall of Fame stop and go and probably a bunch of other stuff that I'll never figure out because I can't read. Okay, I can read. I just don't feel like it. Season number 9. Basically, just play Mike and LeBron 38 minutes a game and let the rest of the guys do whatever the hell they want. You know, they're both about to expire, so let me just extend these contracts real quick. Yep, fantastic. And also, just so I don't forget it later, let's add the hyphens, because that would be very, very bad if I forgot. Fantastic. I've neither of them been captains yet. Jalen Smith, 1-time All-Star. Oh boy, Kyrie's trying to take the title of, MVP. LeBron's playing, I wouldn't say he's playing better than Mike, but who the hell knows? Does it really matter? We're teammates, you know? Good friends, haha, chemistry, all that weird stuff. Michael Jordan, 3-time MVP. Because he's Michael Jordan, what do you expect? Actually, I mean, I didn't expect either one of them to win a lot of MVPs, honestly. Wilford, Mike, DPOY for, my God, what is this? The 6-time Alec Hurley. And Lucas, we won 62 games. Mike and LeBron are pretty good at the basketball thing. And Orlando, you want to just move real quick before I talk about the stats even? Yeah, great. Sorry to any Orlando fans, just bodying your team right now. I mean, yeah, they're averaging pretty similar numbers. In Miami, D'Angelo Russell, Nasir Little. Oh, and Jalen Green, the G League guy. Yeah, here we go. 4-0. Toronto, is Kevin still here? Nope, he's gone. DeAndre Ayton and Bol Bol are, though. That's kind of scary, but are we really that scared with Michael Jordan and LeBron James? Maybe a little bit, but not enough. The NBA Finals against the Dallas Mavericks and George King. I just realized that Ibu Dianko Baji is our starting center. Where the hell do all these new people come from? Well, I guess trades, like any regular NBA team. All right, Dallas. Luka guy is cool, but yeah, first game's gonna go to us. Mike dropped 49 on Luka's head, and Bron dropped 40, 10, and 12. Okay, well, we lost the next one. I guess William Floyd is better than all these guys. William Floyd made as many shots as LeBron on 10 less shots. We know who the real GOAT is now. But yeah, we lost. Cool, another one. The hell, William. 31, 10, and 6 from Mike. Okay, well, okay, we lost. 2-2. The deciding game. Game, what is this, 5? Yeah, 5. And we lost. We lost because, I don't know. Can you really get... I don't have many reasons when, like, we have Mike... Oh, my God. Damon, 1 for 10. Why do we pass the ball, Mike and LeBron? Just keep it to yourself. One of you could stay on the court at all times, and that's all we need. We have a luxury here. Well, we're down in the series, so can we just... Okay, there we go. We force a game 7. Game 7 in New York. We've already had a lot of these, and we got blown out. We got blown out. Yeah, I don't really know what happened. I don't know. Luka, 25 on 7 for 20. As yeah, that's it. For this season, at least. Mike couldn't get his mic ring just yet. But hey, we got time, I guess, right? Here's their playoff numbers. Melvin Frazier Jr. retired. Remember Lionel Hollins? Yeah, me neither. Why is it a count? Mike has 21 Hall of Fame badges. LeBron is, I think, yeah, he has 12. I mean, hey, 12 is still a lot of Hall of Fame badges. What am I going to do? Complain? Season number 10. Well, finally, Mike's a captain. Look at that loyalty. He drafted LeBron, although it was after Giannis. RJ Barrett, one-time All-Star. Happy to see him thriving. Well, looks like we got the MVP on lock. So, considering I just said that, De'Aaron Fox would probably win it. Yeah, Michael Jordan has a lot of MVPs. There goes another one. And another DPOY, because why the hell not? Alexander Ross, Lucas, 65 wins. LeBron and Mike on the first team. LeBron's stats are not too shabby himself. He's actually really good at the whole basketball thing, you know? And yeah, here we are in the playoffs again, because where the hell else will we be? Giannis, I'm sorry that we've ruined your career, but we're probably going to continue to do so, right? Yeah, quick 4-2 win. Second round, Toronto, thank you very much. Boston, third round, and thank you very much again. And Spurs, you know what? You want to just move two real quick? 3-0. You know what? Can I just submit the round? Do I have permission? Yeah, let's just do it. 4-0 sweep. Michael Jordan averaged 41, 11, and 10 in the finals. What the hell? Second game put up 50, while Bron still put up 33. Fourth game, LeBron put up 48. Actually, that was third game. My bad. Yeah, you get it. We're pretty good at the whole basketball thing. They're coexisting together perfectly, just how Bron anticipated. For championship number 6. Yes, I'm mentioning that during the retirement screen. Devon Carter retired. Oh no, Luke Williams retired. Armando. LeBron James and Michael Jordan seem to pretty much be LeBron James and Michael Jordan at this point. As we head into season number 11, Marvin Bagley III, one-time All-Star. I should probably stop checking the MVP race. We kind of get it. They're always going to be at the top. You know, they're Michael Jordan and LeBron James, for God's sake. Let's just be more surprised year by year. How many MVPs is this now? The man has 5. This is with LeBron James on his team. Chucky Arthur. Another DPOY, because why the hell not? Bojan Jovanovic. Lucas, hello. LaMelo Ball, All-NBA first team. Dante Hendricks, son of future. Milwaukee, I'm sorry, Giannis. I don't even got to look at your team no more. I already know it's over. Yup. By the way, LeBron and Jordan are just absolutely dominating. Just for further clarification, but maybe Bron deserved the MVP this year. I don't know. They're pretty neck and neck. They're both top 3 in scoring in the whole league on the same team as we sweep Philadelphia. Kevin Porter Jr. and Mitchell Robinson still in the Celtics. We should have just kept the man. Well, thank you very much, Boston. We'll just get right by you. Right, maybe? Okay, cool. 4-2. Utah, you just had the first pick a couple years ago. Congratulations on your success. Now you run into Michael Jordan and LeBron James. We're up 3-0 just like that. I love when you can just click simulate round and it works. LeBron James, 38 points, 9 rebounds, and 9 assists in the finals. Put 45 in game 4 for our 7th NBA championship in 11 years. For the record, they haven't broken any sort of like playoff points record just yet. Mike's original one from 1986 is still standing strong. Tristan Thompson retired. Sacramento, why would you ever trade your pick? You're the Kings. Funny how I call everybody Kings, but Sacramento Kings are the complete opposite. Hey, look who it is. Sid Tiggs somehow making an appearance for like the 11th video. Leave it up to 2K's auto-generated names to do stuff. I don't think Mike, this has to be some sort of fluke, right? No way he just regressed. Regardless, he's a 98 for God's sake. It's like, my God, Damon Kerr, why are you so good? You may have lost Mitchell Robinson, but this guy has been pretty good for, actually, he doesn't really do anything, but he's at 89, so that's good enough. Aside from him, we don't even have another 80 overall player at this point, but we have to spend a lot of money on the two guys that are incredible at basketball, you know? Speaking of spending money, this guy just got a 5-year, $200 million deal. Jesus. For 9 points per game. Season number 12. Hey, well, there goes LeBron with his own team. Fantastic. And look, he drafted Mike first. Oh, wow. Now, why would Luka not draft Mike over Zion? It's probably the rivalry. You'd have to think that Luka, Zion, and Giannis just hate these guys. They've been teamed up for 87 years and have won, like, almost every single championship and MVP. LeBron James, in his 12th year, averaged 33 points, 9 rebounds, and 7 assists to win his first ever MVP. It took a minute, but he got one. At the very least, one. Bol Bol, still the 6th man of the year and the king himself. He's been on Toronto literally this whole entire time, except for his, you know, normal Denver Denver first year. And Michael Jordan, still the best defensive player because he's Michael Jordan. Rex, Lucas, Bojan, and a playoff run. My God, wait, Milwaukee. I just feel bad at this point. Can I see who was on your team? Giannis, Cam Reddish. Yeah, my bad, my guys. Yeah, you're never going to win anything. Well, Chicago has us at 2-2, so that's kind of scary, but there we go. Another round against Philadelphia like we do every single year. We beat them down again. And John Collins and Chet Holmgren in the finals. Come on, Mike. Come on. Whoa, we lost. We lost by 3 points in game 7 to Chet and Erno Sizemari. Yep, that just happened. Fantastic. Well, LeBron had 24, 16, 8 on 7 for 20 shootings, which is a very weird stat line. But nonetheless, despite him and Michael Jordan being him and Michael Jordan, we lost by 3. Otto Porter retired. Ed Pickaninny, or whatever the hell that is out of here. Amon Mendez and Ion Calmushi. I wish we could have seen what happened in that game 7, but honestly, I was just starting to take for granted that we were God mode. Can you blame me? Look at the first two guys on our team. You see that? Not like you've been watching the whole video or anything. I was going to say, I wonder what day that Damon Kerr is going to take the reins of the franchise. Then I remember that Damon Kerr is older than Michael Jordan and LeBron James. So yeah, you're like just a destined third option. Deion Johnson is here. Neither one of them has ever broke their career highs, but LeBron got pretty close. Season number 13. Imagine they're like number 1 and number 2 on the scoring list all time at the end of this. By the way, we have a 75 overall point guard and a 76 center. But we probably had that for a couple of years, honestly. Team LeBron and Team Luka. Man, they always draft each other. They're really like loyal at this whole basketball thing. Greg Brown, one-time All-Star. LeBron James, once again, the most valuable player. I mean, for the most part, he's averaging the same numbers he's been averaging for like 15 years, but I guess Mike is just kind of, I don't know, chilling right now. Yeah, he's kind of just chilling. He said, Bron, you could have a couple. They're good friends, you know? They're just toying with the league at this point as, oh my God, speaking of toying with the league, 71-11. Surprised we haven't had already like a 70-some win season. Larry Bradley, All-NBA third team. Sheldon Dudley. And Toronto, yeah, sorry, but you got to move real quick. I know that we lost a championship last year, but we should get back there pretty easily, right? Washington, Wendell Moore, and Eldon Miles. Yeah, nah. You know, it is interesting to see. Really? Really? We lost to Donovan Mitchell. Oh, well, they have Rui, of course. That's why they won. Well, okay, then. Oh, okay, okay. They got Leftos. I thought it was Leftos, like most of these leagues. It's Left Terrace, Diamanamanama. Okay, yeah, that's why we lost. Great. So we all of a sudden, we're not good at basketball. This is scary, but it adds some conflict, I guess, and maybe we win the next 8. I don't know. Miles Bridges retired. Not Jock Vaughn. 99 overall. You can't really get much better than that, you know? Actually, well, you can't. Damon Kerr, welcome to the 90 club. You've touched the ball combined, like, let's say, like 36 times over the past 10 years. Season number 14. Clifton, our starting point guard's a 72. Let's just not act. We're going to act like we didn't see that, all right? He's never not going to draft Mike, huh? Why have I not, like, acknowledged the fact that LeBron James Jr. exists? And who the hell cares? LeBron James, back to back to back. You know, light work. Cam Dennis and Michael Jordan. Also known as, well, Michael Jordan. Lucas. How many coach years did he have? Probably, like, 12. Greg Brown, All-NBA first team. So it's been a couple years since we've been good at the whole basketball thing. So can we, like, rejuvenate ourselves this year? Okay, so far, we there we go. We blew out everybody in the East. Now, LA, we're gonna take a little bit easier with you, all right? We're gonna simcast a little bit, because, A, we haven't seen LeBron and Mike in action in a while, and B, we keep losing. First game's a win. Clifton Garrett, thank you for the 30. Second game is a win. LeBron and Mike, thank you for 26. Fourth game, once again a win. For a second, I thought we had Mikey Williams instead of Mark Williams. I thought we had the greatest team of all time. Well, we probably already do. We're just on the verge of winning a light championship number 8. Just one more game. You know, it's actually kind of close, but maybe not close enough. Yep, not close enough. It's been a minute since we saw a celebration. Championship number 8. Only 3 more rings away from, tying the Bill Russell guy. Do they ever start to get bored? Well, okay, not this year since we lost the past 2 years, but whatever, you know what I mean. Well, actually, maybe that's why we lost, because we got bored. They want to give the rest of the league some hope. LeBron Finals MVP. Hello, Bill Russell. You're probably like, what, like 112 at this point. Eldon Miles, good try. Not enough. LeBron, 39-11-12 as he gets the Finals MVP. And Mike, 35-7-7. Not too shabby, you know? 27-11-9 per game for him in these finals. LeBron has been starting to take the initiative in the past couple years, but we're not going to act like Mike is far behind at all. Like, at all. Like, he's literally just averaging like 1 less rebound. Ooh, boy. Michael Porter Jr. retired. They can't really progress anymore, you know? Season number 15. For emphasis, just to say this again, only 3 more from tying Mr. Bill Russell. Dylan Arthur, 71 overall starting center. Look at the best friends always united somehow. I mean, hey, it's a pretty good rivalry. Luka and Trey versus LeBron and Mike. I would definitely not watch that, for Christ's sake. Mike and LeBron would body them. All right, Bron, we're starting to get it. You're kind of good at the whole basketball thing. You're really trying to catch up with Mike at this point. Anderson Varejao's son, Anderson Davis. Yep, you heard me. I have no clue what's going on. Michael Jordan, DPOY. Luke. So Mike didn't make the first team of the NBA this year, but he made the second team. Fine by me, I guess. I mean, he's done enough. Can we repeat, please? That'd be kind of cool. Boston, please don't beat us in the first round. Thank you very much. Brooklyn, same to you. And Washington, oh God, we're down 3-2. I feel like Dr. Seuss right now. Yep, we lost. We lost to Washington again in the conference finals. LeBron, 35-7-6. 36, but not enough. He averaged 31, 10, and 7 in the playoffs. Mike averaged 23, Mike and Mike. Memphis versus Washington, incredible final series. Bam Adebayo, congrats. We don't care. Precious Chihuahua retired. Kenny. Yes, the good old Blazers, the home of Terry Stotts, retired like 15 years ago. LeBron James, Michael Jordan, Damon Kerr, the greatest big three of all time. Let's see what happens this season. Maybe we won't lose. Walker Kessler, Chris Mullin's son. All right, Bron, it's getting kind of weird. You could pick like Bam, maybe. You don't have to pick Mike every year. So wait, Bron has how many MVPs? LeBron has 5, and Mike has 5. They're now tied. It doesn't feel like it since Mike was dominating for a bunch of years, but so was LeBron now. The difference is, well, Mike has 13 DPOIs, for God's sake. But who won the MVP battle? Well, I don't know. All I know is that Lucas is the greatest coach of all time at this point. Benjamin Macy. Orlando, you guys want to move real quick? It'd be really, really, really positive. Thank you very much. Hey, Predrag Olic, our starting center, against Bam, who we keep losing to every year. Wait, what was that guy's name? Oh, that was Lefteris Diamanamanama. Right. Forgot about him. Here we go. We're down 3-0. And I'm really on my Dr. Seuss game today. All right, Colin Sexton, you might want to move real quick because, I'm trying to get to the... Oh, God. I can already feel this going wrong. Oh, wait. Hold on. It's 2-3. Can we just come back real quick? No. We're just going to... Okay, fine. Yeah, I guess we tried. I mean, LeBron's LeBron, Jordan's Jordan. Those LeBron's playoff numbers. And, well, here's Mike's. Look, man, I don't know what's going on. Wizards won another ring led by Bam Bam. Markelle Fultz retired. Assistant coach Tim Duncan retired. 35 years old. In case you don't remember, I gave him the same exact birthday because why the hell not? Going into season number 17, neither has yet to regress. And they've won 8 rings in those 16 years. So only half for a team that has the 2 greatest players of all time. Can I really say only for 8 rings, though? Do I sound like an idiot? Yeah, I definitely do. Why won't they ever be just both of, like, why can't they just both be team captains? And why can't LeBron just draft Christopher Graves once? Doesn't always have to be Mike. You know, you've only been playing with him for 17 years. LeBron officially wins his 6th MVP to surpass Mike. Fred Brown. LeBron James Jr., 6th man of the year. And Mike DPOY for the 46th time. Zach Dudley, who just looks like an off-brand James Harden. It's like when you buy the organic version of cereals. And good old Lucas. Telling you, Brown, Christopher Graves, he's pretty good. JT Hart, Luka Doncic, Bojan Jovanovic, and Russell's son, Trey. Who really could be Russell's son at this juncture. Well, we swept the first round, second round. Thank you very much, Sixers. Right, yep, great. Third round, the Hornets, and we're back in the finals. Shea and Burt. Are we going to lose to Shea and Burt? Like, seriously, come on now. Yep, we're down 2-1. Here we go. You know, they used to have run-ins with, like, Clyde Drexler, that Mike, that is. But Shea and Burt? Yeah, I guess so. But we're up by 1 with 31 seconds left, and I think they're at the line. Or no, we need a defensive stop. Game 4, 31 seconds. What the hell? Why'd you just take a timeout so immediately? Soto with the ball. Soto going right. He has all the room in the world because the guy does not believe him on the defensive end. And layup is off. Rebounded by us. Yeah, that should do it. Mike, please just be clutch real quick. Thank you very much. 2 for 2. Has he ever missed a free throw before in his life? I don't know. Can Shea hit a 3 real quick to put some pressure on us? Well, he has Michael Jordan on him, and not everyone can really score on Michael Jordan. You know, he's only won 13 defensive players of the year. Shea over to Soto. Soto just completely contested, misses a shot, and that's going to do it. Let me not waste no more of my time. 2-2. You know, this Cliff and Garrett guy has been pretty good. If only we can give him some more rings. We even won a ring in 3 years. It's a lot of years. All right, cool. We won this game, right? Yep, incredible. LeBron, 30, 11, and 12. Mike, 26, 11, and 12. We need one more game for ring number 9. Come on, Bill. You can't hold that record for too much longer. Oh, God. Here we go. Oh, we still won. LeBron, 28, 9, and 9. As another finals MVP goes to his hands. Shea retired. Lucas has won so many coaches of the year. He's probably going to have to get inducted to the Hall of Fame twice. LeBron and Jordan. Jordan and LeBron. James and Michael. That just sounds so weird. I'm never saying that again. Season number 18. We have a pretty solid lineup. You know, with Michael Jordan, LeBron James, aside from Sylvester Powers. Look at Lucas. He got another new suit. I mean, you'd expect something to change every, you know, couple years or so when you are the coach of a team for like 15, 16, 17, 18 years. Hey, Mike regained his little team of the All-Star game. You look at LeBron. He doesn't reciprocate that same loyalty. He drafted Kuminga before you. How do you feel? Not like he won 46 straight MVPs. LeBron James, 7-time MVP. Usually it'd be unrealistic being the MVP race at 37. We never know when this guy's actually going to regress. Trent Carroll, Rookie of the Year. And Michael Jordan. How many is this? 15. I don't even know who's contesting him at this point. Giannis probably has like faded away by now. Trace Day, 6th man of the year. Trace Day, most improved player. Oh boy. The first year ever where Lucas is in the coach of the year in like, I don't know, 2 decades. Sounds a lot wilder when you like express it as 2 decades. It's a very long time. There's one hell of an All-NBA first team. Hello, JT Hart. Clifton Garrett versus Pat Battle, the greatest matchup of the century. And we won 4-3. Jesus, that was close. Second round, and we lost. We lost by 7 points in game 7, which is a very common thing for us at this point. We keep losing in game 7s or whatever round, or just game anything. I don't know. I don't think we should be losing this much with Michael Jordan, LeBron James on our team, you know? Alex Antetokounmpo. Oh my God. That is going to do it for career 1 out of 2. After 18 years pro at 37 years old, LeBron James has retired. This has to be one of the most shocking retirements I've ever seen. This guy, he still had a couple years left. You know, he's won MVP like 6 years straight, or actually 7. I mean, I guess he was just tired of losing. If you really look at it from like an objective standpoint here, 2031, we won a championship. 2034, 2037. We've had 3 years in between each one for a team with Mike and LeBron. But anyways, now Mike's going to be alone as he's not out of here just yet. So at the end of this career, LeBron James finishes with 28 points per game, 7 rebounds, 7 assists, 2 steals, 1 block, 53 from the field, 45 from downtown, and 70 from the line. He had 68 triple-doubles and 523 double-doubles. Never beat out his career high of 61 points, but he actually had 58 this season, which was a league high. LeBron finishes 4th on the all-time scoring list with 40,635, 7th in field goals, 11th in threes, 18th in free throws made, 79th in rebounds, 19th in assists, 55th in blocks, and 5th in steals, while he was 6th in 40-point games with 125, and 10th in 50-point games with 12, as well as 10th in triple-doubles with 68. And well, we'll save the team records for after, you know, like Mike's career is over. But last but not least, his award history, 7 MVPs, 9 championships, 16 All-Star appearances, 16 first-team All-NBA, 2 second-team, 12 first-team All-Defense, and 4 second-team All-Defense, as well as Rookie of the Year and first-team All-Rookie. That's one hell of a resume. You decide if he stacked up better than Mike, I don't know. And well, will LeBron James make the Hall of Fame? Of course he will, obviously he's LeBron James. What do you expect? If there's anything I could have told you before this, it was that he's going to make the Hall of Fame. And of course, his number 6 retired by the Knicks. So hey, everything went well there, but surprisingly enough, he retired very early, and you can cut off the music now, because we've still got another career to finish out. I say you can cut off the music like I'm not the one who edits these. Mike's still not regressing. He's 37. But then again, this is probably around the time like when he hit that shot over the Jazz, you know? Pretty good for a pretty old guy. Damon Kerr, 40 years old, still holding on strong. Can Mike compete for a championship and win another MVP or something like that with, you know, no LeBron? He still could have a couple years left. Team Michael and Team Mikey. I told you, LeBron, he was going to draft Christopher Graves. He's the clear-cut favorite for MVP. Michael Jordan regains his MVP status as, you know, well, his guy retired. Number 6 for him, Nell Fletcher. And well, Mike, how many DPOYs is this? It's 16, for God's sake. Which might be more than we've ever seen anybody win. Lucas still coach of the year, so hey, we're still pretty good at the basketball thing, I guess. I never checked who took LeBron's place. Oh, well, obviously Damon Kerr, as we have Jared Jeffries' son, Jesse Jeffries. And actually a better overall team now that LeBron's gone. I guess we have money now, you know? What happens when a guy who's on like a $300 million contract leaves? Well, first round Philadelphia, thank you very much. Second round, oh God, it's the Wizards. And we're down 3-2. Come on, Mike. We know you're better than this. You can't lose to the team that you use as your retirement home. Fantastic. You dropped 29, 19, and 14 to force a game 7. And yep, game 7's a win. 33 for Mike. So far, absolutely dominating. 31 and 10. Orlando, can Michael Jordan beat you? Yeah, probably. Your team isn't that good. If we lose, I won't even be mad because I won't even know what's happening. All right, great. The finals against Kuminga and Mo Bamba. Now this one, it's kind of scary. Oh, we lost the first game. We won the second game. Lose the third. Lose the fourth. Mike's kind of trying, you know? And we only have one more game until it's over with. So I'm assuming, yep, there it goes. Kuminga, 29 points in the finals as we lose by 5 points in game 5. He dropped 40 on Mike's head. Well, probably he's not guarded by Mike, but whatever. Mike had 28, 9, and 10. He averaged, well, Mike numbers more than likely. Let me just take a look. Yep, Mike numbers. Actually, no, 10 rebounds is a lot better than you would think. And that is officially going to do it. Honestly, they could have both retired at 38, and I still would have been surprised. But obviously, now that LeBron retired, I'm not that surprised. Michael Jordan has retired from the NBA after 19 years in the league. He averaged 27 points, 7 rebounds, 7 assists, 3 steals on 62 from the field, 32 from 3, and 85 from the line in his career, along with 42 triple-doubles, 461 double-doubles. He never beat out his career high of 69 points, but he did set new ones with 21 rebounds in this season specifically. And when it comes to the NBA records, he finishes 3rd all-time in points with 42,309, more than LeBron. But field goals made, I actually saw this last year. He has 17,500. That's the most ever by far. More than Kareem. Threes made, you would have thought he shot threes. Free throws made, number 13. Rebounds, number 67. Assists, number 21. Steals, number 1 by far, with 700 more or so than John Stockton. Also number 2 in turnovers, though. While Bron was 22nd in that category. Also, Bron did have a higher points per game than he did in his actual career. Wow. By 0.1. But Mike did not. 94 40-point games, which is 11. And 6 50-point games, which is 21st. His actual career, he had 31 compared to, what did I just say, 6? Yeah, that's a big difference. We all know he had 173 40-point games in his actual career. In this one, he had 94. So yeah, he had almost double in his actual career. That's what happens when you have LeBron on your team. You have to share the sugar, you know? 15th in triple-doubles with 42. The 6 most field goals made in a season with 1,100. Neither one of them set any regular season records. Mike had the 4th most field goals made in a playoff game. And the 3rd most turnovers in a playoff game with 10. And well, for the team records, Melo still reigns supreme when it comes to the, you know, Knicks records. But LeBron had 59 and 58. Mike is not top 5. So we don't even know what Mike ever dropped in his career high, you know? But he did have 25 field goals in a game. He had 9 steals in a game, the most ever. Well, tied. LeBron tied for the most turnovers in the Knicks game history, and Mike had third. Mike dropped 50 in a playoff game while LeBron dropped 52 and a bunch more. LeBron made 8 threes in a playoff game a lot of times. LeBron made 20 free throws in a playoff game while Mike made 16. Mike had 7 blocks in a playoff game while LeBron had 6. Mike had 7 steals in a game multiple times, as well as played 51 minutes. Last but not least, his award history. 6 MVPs, 9 championships, 17 All-Star appearances, 13 first-team All-NBA, 2 second-team All-NBA, 1 third-team All-NBA, 16-time DPOY, not allowing Brown to even try for 1, 18-time first-team All-Defense, 1 second-team All-Defense, 1 first-team All-Rookie, and yeah, that is it. I really wish Lucas would have retired. It'd been really, like, you know, fitting, but instead, Twin Olsen retired. Of course, Michael Jordan is a Hall of Famer. We all know this. And lastly, his number 45, of course, retired by the New York Knicks, which is cool. You know, gave him some new numbers and all that cool stuff. But that is officially gonna do it. Thank you for watching. Once again, the Click Productions merch is available at the top of the bio, as well as the pinned comment link. I know I already asked you to like, but you know, you could subscribe to the channel if you care about my channel at all. You just stood around here for a while, you might as well. Thank you for 150,000 subscribers. Shout out to my social medias, they'll be in the description. Let me know what you want to see next, and I'm out of here. Cut.